What if you sat down and just made a short video like that? Are you actually reading the Yu-Gi-Oh card, right? What if you made a little short video about that? About, like, are you actually reading these Yu-Gi-Oh cards? And, you know, most of the time, I'm like, I don't think TCG is actually reading the Yu-Gi-Oh cards and giving an opinion or an idea that would be good or healthy for the card game. And it starts with two cards. It really just starts with Nibiru and Dimensional Shifter. I get it. Maybe you hate it when somebody activates Dimensional Shifter on you, but guess what? Here's the newsflash with Dimensional Shifter. It does not top as much. Check. Dimensional Shifter, when it activates, it can go through and it can activate, but you still can't clutch for game. So Dimensional Shifter, that's a common card that a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh people talk about on YouTube, right? And that is a pointless conversation. It really is. It's a pointless conversation. The card has to meet a certain little requirement. And the problem is you don't know if you're going to get the card or not, or you don't know how it's going to go. But most of the duels you actually see with Dimensional Shifter is just, you know, they lose. So that's what you see with Dimensional Shifter. But then people get mad when you bring up Nibiru, but Nibiru is fair to bring up, and nobody's like looking into how fair it is to bring up Nibiru, because Nibiru, okay, if you were to say that Nibiru has cons, of course it has cons. It's Yu-Gi-Oh, of course it does. But guess what? It has more pros. See what I'm saying? Nibiru has more pros. It has more ideas of how you can use that card, right? Okay, genius. You know what I'm saying? It has more ideas that you can use that card, and it has versatility, right? So it's a card. It's almost like this card can be a main deck and it can be a side deck. See what I'm saying? And what I mean by that is this card could be a side deck that can change outcomes that's probably not healthy for the Yu-Gi-Oh card game, because it's not healthy for the Yu-Gi-Oh card game, right? It's not healthy. But, like, when you read two contexts, I think that's the dumbest thing in America, is, like, when you read two paragraphs of two different cards, right? But you're just, like, somewhere in your head, you're, like, having a bunch of people say Shifter, but it's, like, no, read Nibiru. Nibiru can do whatever. Nibiru can stay in the hand, or you can play it early, or you can play it in the middle. It's really that simple, that Nibiru can do a lot of things. It does way too much. That card does way too much. That card makes people kind of like a constructed win, a win condition. It's like a card. Nibiru is a win condition. You may not, maybe some of the scenarios, Nibiru is not what you would consider, right? But like what happens is you'll get into a person that's building Yu-Gi-Oh deck or building some kind of combo, and you'll be like, I got Nibiru, and I know Nibiru is going to win it for me, but I know Shifter's not going to win it for me. You know, that's the thing that you know. But that was the voice of the opinion. So is that the actual problem too in Yu-Gi-Oh? Yes, the voice from the human being. Not just me, but the voice from the actual human being, the other human beings, right? It's the funny part of that. Okay, if I know in TCG you don't know what you're talking about when you make a video on YouTube and you talk about Yu-Gi-Oh, then me, Konami, I'm going to know that you don't know about my card game, right? And since you don't make fair arguments about my card game, and you just continue to purchase products, this is the Yu-Gi-Oh you get. This is the exact Yu-Gi-Oh you get. You get all this saliva out of my mouth. Saliva out of my mouth on the idea that you would think to this. That's the point of opinion. If you want to be noticed in Yu-Gi-Oh, because I got noticed on the recent ban list. I got noticed on the last ban list, right? If you want to get noticed in the Yu-Gi-Oh community or get some idea, you're going to have to be really hard on yourself. And as soon as you're hard on yourself, that will be better. Dimensional Shifter, I'm actually glad there's a card like Dimensional Shifter. I want to tell you why I'm glad there's a card like Dimensional Shifter. Dimensional Shifter is good card design. Nibiru? That's not good card design. Tribute gets around everything in Yu-Gi-Oh! What are you trying to talk about with Yu-Gi-Oh, right? Yu-Gi-Oh's mechanics are very kind of simple, but you just have to keep grinding at it. You know, you got to see a lot of duels. But then once you've seen enough Yu-Gi-Oh duels, then you say to yourself, oh, I see why this card's a problem. Oh, okay. Dimensional Shifter's actually a fair card. Wow, how's it a fair card? Well, I'm risking on activating it. Mm-hmm. And I'm risking that I can actually finish the card game, because I can't finish the card game sometimes, and then I play the card, I've lost the game. But instead, I'm not reading the right context on the card. I'm not reading the Yu-Gi-Oh card. So until that is fixed for Yu-Gi-Oh players, this is the card game you got.